difficulties. I guess it's on now. I'm going to stand back here. Okay. Sorry for the technical difficulties. Please remain standing for the invocation, who will be provided by Assistant Professor of Nursing, Ms. Denise Kinney.
Thanks, Dr. Reuter, but I'm an Italian from New York. I don't need a microphone. To be a nurse. Being a nurse means you'll never be bored. You will always be frustrated. You will be surrounded by challenges. So much to do in so little time. You will carry immense responsibility and very little authority. You will step into people's lives and you'll make a difference. Some will bless you, some will curse you. You will see people at their worst and at their best. You will never cease to be amazed at people's capacity for love, courage, and endurance. You will see life begin and end. You will experience resounding triumphs and devastating failures. You will cry a lot. You will laugh a lot. You will laugh a lot. You will know what it is to be human and to be humane. Congratulations, my baby ducks. I'm so very proud of all of you.
Thank you, Denise. As a coordinator of the Associate Degree Nursing Program, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Fall 2020 live-streamed ADN Nursing Pinning Ceremony. It is unfortunate that we can't assemble here with our friends, loved ones, and family members here in the audience due to the ongoing pandemic, but we are pleased to be able to have a ceremony with mask and social distancing to celebrate this important milestone in the lives of our nursing program graduates. Please be seated. The YouTube link is not working. Okay, there's a Gulf Coast link. Let's let everybody know to try the Gulf Coast link.
Not the YouTube link?
Well, there's two links in case the Gulf Coast, in case the YouTube wasn't working. We'll take a pause. And I think we could go ahead and sit down, if everybody wants to go ahead and sit down. Thank you. Give everybody a moment to put in the Gulf Coast link or send a message. The link. It is working? Okay. Technology. Are you ready for me to proceed? Yes? Okay. All right, we'll try again. This pinning ceremony marks the completion of one of the most rigorous and demanding programs the college has to offer. So I would like to take a moment to thank, to introduce the platform guest. We have Dr. Rebecca Leach at the far side. We have Dr. Scott Kirkland. We have Nancy Gibson and Denise Kinney, who are faculty members of the nursing program. Dr. Holnack was going to be here, but he was not able to come today, unfortunately. But I would like to take a moment to thank the students as well as the nursing faculty and support staff for their hard work and dedication during these past four very demanding semesters. The faculty and staff have worked diligently to provide a quality nursing education for the students, and I might add, under extremely challenging conditions. I would like to thank Dr. Laura Justice, Chair of the Health Science Division, and Dr. Holly Keener, Vice President of Academic Affairs, for their support and guidance during these challenging times also. Normally, I would turn the podium over to Dr. Holnack to provide some congratulatory remarks. But instead, we are going to proceed with the presentation of the pending awards. So as the program coordinator, it is my honor to present the Nursing Department Awards. Before I proceed, I would like to take a moment to thank friends, family, relatives of these students for your support to these students over the last 2 years. We are glad that you're joining us via the live stream link. Hopefully it's working. We are very fortunate that we have been able to continue the program using a variety of virtual and remote online formats, enabling the students here today to complete the program despite numerous challenges and obstacles presented by Hurricane Michael and the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. Transitioning to remote and hybrid teaching learning formats in an extremely short period of time is a testament to the strength and dedication of the students and faculty alike. These students have shown remarkable resilience and strength. We could not be more proud of them today, so let's give them a round of applause. It is tradition for the nursing faculty to nominate and select the recipients of the Nursing Department Pinning Awards. These awards are given to students exemplifying the characteristics of each award. So the first award is the Scholastic Achievement Award. This award is given to the graduate who achieved the highest grade point average calculated on their Gulf Coast State College transcript and throughout the completion of the nursing curriculum. So it includes the support courses, the prerequisite courses, and the nursing courses. This award presents an outstanding achievement. To receive this award, the recipient must be committed to excellence and meet the difficult and numerous challenges presented in the nursing program. The student who will receive this award has consistently maintained the highest level of academic success within the nursing program and has achieved the highest overall GPA in this cohort. With an overall GPA of approximately 3.77, the final grades haven't been posted yet, but that's based on my calculations. The recipient of the Fall 2020 Scholastic Achievement Award goes to, drumroll, Lori Cruz. So is Lori in the audience? I don't believe she is. Thank you. Okay, but Lori, we are very proud of your achievements, and I'm sure your friends and family and classmates are proud of you too. She earned an A in advanced adult course, which is quite an achievement, so way to go, Lori. Okay, let's go to the second award. The second award is the Outstanding Student Nurse Award. This award is presented to the graduate who demonstrates a high degree of clinical expertise and professionalism during the program and in the clinical setting. According to the faculty, this student was a fantastic clinical leader. She was supportive to her fellow students, prepared excellent and exceptional detailed clinical paperwork, never shied away from challenges, and I'm told that her, quote, patients loved her. The recipient of this award is Alicia Pitts, and please come to the podium, Ms. Alicia. Okay, the next award is the Outstanding Leadership Award. This award is given to the graduate who has exhibited outstanding leadership skills, not only among classmates, but also within the nursing profession. The student selected by this faculty for the award demonstrated leadership abilities throughout the program. I have heard that this individual is very mature, supports her peers, is a good class representative, and is active in the Nursing Student Association. She worked very hard in the clinical setting, brought fellow students together, and did well academically. Demonstrating a consistently positive attitude, the recipient of this award is Jennifer Kerr. Jennifer, please come to the podium. So next is the history of pinning, which Ms. Gibson is going to come and tell you about the history of the pinning ceremony.
Hello. Well, you all have come a long way in the last several semesters, and today, not only are you graduating, but you'll be receiving a mark of achievement, your nursing pin. The nursing pin is a 1,000-year-old symbol of service to others. And that is what each of you has decided to do with your choice of becoming a nurse. You're going to serve others. Throughout history, various symbols have been used to identify these caregivers. Early symbols included the Maltese cross, the emblems worn by the guilds, and the gold and silver medals given to nurses to symbolize professional achievement. During the medieval period, caregivers in monasteries and convents were identified by the habits they wore. During the Crusades, a group of men known as the Knights of the Order of the Hospital of St. John the Baptist cared for injured crusaders. When new monks were initiated into the order, they vowed to serve the sick and wounded soldiers. In this initiation ceremony, each monk was given a Maltese cross. While on the battlefield, these men wore black tunics over their armor, carried no weapons, and wore the white Maltese cross across their necks, around their necks. The tradition of the nursing pin began in the 1860s in the most appropriate place, the Nightingale School of Nursing at St. Thomas Hospital in London. Florence Nightingale was awarded the Red Cross of St. George in recognition for her service to the injured during the Crimean War. She then extended this honor to only her most talented students by presenting each of them with a Medal of Excellence. In the 19th century, many hospitals adopted Nightingale's ideas and started their own schools for education and training for nurses. These schools awarded gold or silver medals to students who excelled in their nursing education. Gradually, many of these schools started giving the medal or badge to all graduates of their program. The earliest known nursing pin in the United States was designed for the Bellevue Hospital in New York City. The Bellevue School pin was designed by Tiffany & Company. It was adopted in 1880 and worn by the graduates. The pin included a crane that represented vigilance, surrounded by a wreath of poppies, signifying the role of nurses in relieving pain and bringing rest to the suffering, and an unbroken circle of blue with the word Bellevue at the bottom to represent constancy. I hope the pin that you receive today is only the first of several you obtained during your nursing career. This pin identifies you as a graduate of the Gulf Coast State College Associate Degree Nursing Program, but I hope all of you go on to receive a nursing pin from a baccalaureate program or even a doctorate program. The nursing pin, being unique to each school, identifies the source of the nurse's education. But more importantly, it conveys a message to patients and families that you, Gulf Coast State College graduate nurses, have successfully completed a rigorous, challenging nursing program, and you are now ready to go serve those in need. Congratulations.
So now it's time for a presentation of the nursing pins. The nursing students seated here today have taken the first step from student to novice practitioners. We have assembled here today to recognize their accomplishments. Dr. Scott Kirkland, a fourth semester faculty, will place the pin on each student as they walk across the stage. While they are being pinned, The students' penning statements with personal words of thanks and plans for the future will be read out loud. So now I would like to ask the first row of students to rise and come forward to the stage on that side to be penned. And also, when you leave the stage, make sure you walk in front of the podium and come around. Okay, so the first student to receive their pen is Nicole Abel. Nicole is from Sarasota, Florida. She would like to thank Dan, Ashton, Adrian, Jenny, Mariah, Denise. Her plans for the future include continuing education in the bachelor's program in January. Thank you, Nicole. Brittany Barker. Brittany has lived in Panama City, Florida for most of his life. He would like to thank his wonderful wife, Charlie Barker, for all the encouragement in late night study sessions. Jennifer Kerr and Ashley Holder for keeping him focused and on task throughout all of nursing school. His kids for helping him with assignments and assessments. Without any one of these people, he still would have passed, but it would have been far more difficult. His immediate plans are to spend as much time with his wife and kids and start the BSN program in the spring. Thank you, Brittany. Alexander Benton. So Alexander is from Panama City, Florida. He was born in Busan, South Korea, and now lives in Panama City. He would like to thank his family, friends, and coworkers at the Pain Clinic of Northwest Florida. He says he plans to do an emergency department nurse residency in Austin, Texas. Yes, I like the bump. Thank you, Benton. Then Centaura Britt. Okay. Thank you. Centaura is from Panama City. She would like to thank God. Special thanks to Mom for being with her throughout this journey. She says, I love you, son. You have been my motivation. Future plans are to work at Bay Medical Center, where she currently works there at the tech. And then she would like to do some travel nursing and specialize in labor and delivery. Thank you. Thank you. Denny Brown. So Denny is from Fayetteville, Georgia. He would like to thank my parents, my partner Greg, and all the staff and classmates who have helped me succeed. His plan is to continue to work in the ER. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Shemaya George. Brown George. I think I messed that up. Shemaya Brown George. She is from Dallas, Texas. She would like to thank everyone who supported me emotionally, spiritually, and financially through this journey. She currently is a CVICU nurse intern at Bay Medical Center and will be relocating to Denver, Colorado to pursue the long-term goal of becoming a flight nurse. Thank you, Shemaya. Okay. Casey Busby. She is originally from Apopka, Florida, but has lived in Walton County since 2004. She would like to thank my family and friends for always being supportive and patient with me through this long journey. Without them, I wouldn't be walking across this stage. She says, I accepted a job offer on a cardiopulmonary PCU unit as a registered nurse in Orlando, Florida. One day, she says, I hope to become a certified registered nurse anesthesiologist. Okay. Thank you. Anthony Carboni, or Carbone, I might have said it right. That right. Is from Panama City Beach. I'd like to thank my parents, family, and friends. Did I say it right? No? Okay. Mm-hmm. Carbone. All right, I heard that. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Yay. Sarah Curley. Sarah would like to thank my family, my friends, and everyone who has supported me along this journey. She's currently working as a nurse intern in the ICU at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay. I would like to continue my career in the ICU and one day further my education. Thank you. Reagan Dakin. Reagan is from Missouri. She would like to thank my mom, stepdad, Trenton, and my nursing friends for being supportive and helping me with Cora. Plans for the future, she plans to go to med school and work with the kids. I plan to relocate eventually wherever I get into med school. Okay, thank you. Sarah Fisher. She would like to thank Sunny O, who's her my mother, Kelly Plumley Cabana, and she says, I am currently a nurse extern on PCU. I would love to become an RN in the emergency department. I would like to further my career by attaining my BSN and eventually my DNP. Thank you. Alexandria Folsom. Alexandria is from Panama City, Florida. She would like to thank my parents, Denise and Manuel Folsom, my siblings, my granny and papa, and my Mima, who watches over me from heaven. I plan on working either in postpartum, NICU, or pediatrics and go back to school to eventually get my master's or DNP. Thank you. Misty Garrett. And Misty is from Connecticut. She says, first and foremost, I would like to thank my husband, Jonathan, and our three children for their incredible and unwavering support through this part of my life. Also, thank you to Team Winning. This journey would have been impossible without each of you. Thank you, Rochelle, for being my best friend and pushing me through. I know you're here for this. She says, yeah, there's a little bit more. Currently, my plan is to work on the cardiovascular floor, that's okay, at Bay, and to become certified in wound care as well. Long term, I plan to go for my BLS in the spring and then follow that up with a CRNA degree. Thank you. Okay, Samantha May Garwick. Samantha is from Overland Park, Kansas. I would like to give thanks to my most amazing kids, CJ and Garrett, for giving me the strength and drive to do my best and the drive to provide the best life I can for them. I would also like to thank my mom. Without her and her support, this would not have been possible. Also, would like to thank Eric for his continued support throughout this program and pushing me to strive for the best. Her plans, she says, I am currently working for a local rheumatologist, but would like to eventually work in labor and delivery and postpartum. Thank you. Okay, Ashley Gonzalez Ardon. Nope. Okay. Kenneth Gonzalez, or Kenny G. He is from Yakima, Washington. People he would like to thank, Kauai, my family, my in-laws, Team Winning, classmates, and the Encompass Health team. He was plans to continue working at Encompass Health. Thank you. I'm going to have to find out. Thank you. I'm going to have to find out what Team Winning is afterwards. Maybe everybody can come tell me what Team Winning is. Okay. Heather Michelle Grock. She is from Panama City. She would like to thank her sons Hunter, Cameron, Ethan, role modeling sister Ingrid, best friend Jennifer, loving and supportive family and friends. Her plans are to work in the mother baby or labor and delivery unit. Thank you, Heather. Nicole Greenway. She is from Incline Village, Nevada. She would like to thank her husband, Owen, her mother, Nellie, her father, Jim, her brother, Kyle, and the family and friends that helped her during her journey through nursing school. She will be beginning in the BSN program at GCSC in January 2021 and plans to begin her career at one of the local hospitals after passing the NCLEX exam. She aspires to become a critical care nurse in the future. Thank you, Nicole. Abby Haddock. She is from Chipley, Florida. She would like to thank her family, friends, and fellow classmates that she has met along the way. This journey has not been easy, and she most certainly would not have gotten through all those sleepless nights without all the encouraging words and support that she received from each of y'all. She currently works as a nurse intern on 5 Cardiac at Bay Medical and hopes to begin working as a nurse on the same unit. Her future plans include advancing to a pediatric nurse working in the cardiac intensive care unit. Thank you. Thank you. Ashley Holder. Ashley is originally from Prattville, Alabama, but has lived in Santa Rosa Beach for most of her life. She would like to thank her parents, Chip and Michelle, her sister, Gracie, and her boyfriend, Zach, for always supporting and encouraging her. She is also thankful for the help of her nursing friends, Jennifer Kerr and Brittany Barker. Ashley's plans for the future include starting the bachelor's program in January and starting work as an RN. Ashley hopes to get a job as a psych nurse and help patients improve their quality of life. Thank you. Breslin Holder. She is originally from Virginia, but grew up in Panama City. She would like to thank my closest friends, Charlie, Lauren, Katie, and Ashley, for always being understanding of my dedication to my education. She says, I plan to continue working at Bay Medical while obtaining my BSN and eventually going on to a master's program. Thank you. Jennifer Kerr. She is from Oceanside, California. She would like to thank my husband, Nathan Kerr, and my 2 beautiful daughters, Rowan and Remy, who have picked up my slack at home and supported me through all the ups and downs nursing school likes to throw at you. To the staff members at Gulf Coast Regional Medical Center on the PCU floor, for embracing me into your family and taking my nursing skills to another level. To the students in my class, you are all so amazing and I am very proud of us. A big special thanks to Ashley and Brittany. You two have been my foundation and support through the entire process from the very beginning. I truly wouldn't be here or made it this far without you both. Thank you for keeping me sane and truly being a friend. Lastly, I would like to thank the professors. These past 2 years have been hard on all of us with the Hurricane Michael and then COVID. Know that your hard work has brought us here today. She says, my goal is to gain experience in critical care, ICU, and in the future obtain my CRNA doctorates. I am currently employed at Gulf Coast Regional Medical Center. Thank you. Tashauna Kinney. She is from Okinawa, Japan. She would like to thank my parents, Patrick and Gina Kinney, all my wonderful friends who help support me. They know who they are, and especially Park Jimin. She says, I will be working in the emergency room of Bay Medical and continuing my education as I enter the BSN program in the spring of 2021. Thank you. Anna Marginiano. I probably didn't say it right. Yeah. She is from Moldova, a small country in Europe. She would like to thank my husband, Dimitri, my parents, Maria and Nikolai. Plans for the future, I am not currently employed in the field, but my passion is labor and delivery. Thank you. Angela McClure. She is from Germany and moved to North Carolina when I was 7. She says, I would like to thank my husband, Ricky Markle. Without him, I would not have made it this far. My 4 wonderful boys. I would also like to thank my dad, Kevin, and mom, Gabri, who supported me through this journey. And I'm honoring my mama, Joyce, who is no longer with us. I look forward to becoming a NICU or PEDS nurse. Thank you. Kevin Parna. Kevin is from Panama City, Florida. He would like to thank my father, George Perna, my mother, Elke Perna, and my brother, Brian Perna. Kevin plans on pursuing cardiovascular intensive care at Ascension Sacred Heart here in Panama City, Florida. Kevin also plans to pursue his bachelor's degree in nursing at Gulf Coast State College and eventually become a nurse anesthetist. And he says, go Commodores. Alicia Pitts. She is from Panama City, Florida. She would like to thank my patient, supportive, and kind-hearted husband, Patrick Pitts, my crazy loving mom, Janice, and stepfather, Danny, my sweet and special darling, Golden Grams, and my friend group, too many to name personally, but y'all know who y'all are. She says, I am currently still employed as full-time paramedic, but I'm excited and looking forward to the new opportunities to come. I hope to begin my career in the emergency department and eventually move to the pediatric ICU. Thank you. Amber Smith. Amber was born and raised in Bay County. She says, first and foremost, I want to thank God for everything he has done for me and for every answered prayer. Without him, I definitely wouldn't have made it this far. I also want to thank my parents, Scott and Angela Smith, my husband, Jonathan Bryant, and all of my family and friends for all the prayers they have prayed for myself and each of my classmates. And I want to thank them for pushing me to succeed and never give up. I love y'all and thank y'all for everything. I am truly blessed. She says, I plan to stay around Bay County for a while, but then eventually I would love to be a travel nurse. My passion is to work with babies, pediatrics, labor and delivery, postpartum NICU, or PICU. I have not decided 100% yet, but I am beyond excited to see where God takes me. Thank you. Sydney Ward. Sydney is from Panama City, Florida. She says, I'd like to thank Jay for standing by my side through all the tears, tests, clinicals, late night studying, and being my cheerleader and my support system through this entire process. She says, I plan to go back to school to receive my bachelor's and then go on to receive my master's and become a nurse practitioner. Thank you. Caitlin Winner. She grew up as a military kid and moved around a lot. Caitlin has lived in Panama City the past 4 years. She would like to thank parents, siblings, and everyone who has given words of encouragement when I needed it. She says she's hoping to start working on a medical surgical unit after graduation to gain experience while continuing to the RN to BSN program at Gulf Coast State College. Thank you. Nikki Whitman. She is from Panama City, Florida. She would like to thank my parents, Craig and Connie, my siblings, Rayford, Molly, and Chad, the Sin family, the Whitman family, and Tyler. Also, my children, Jax and Genova. She's currently employed as a nurse intern at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay, SICU, planning to begin as an RN in the SICU after graduation. We'll be continuing into the BSN program in the next year. Thank you. Kristen Williams. Kristen is originally from North Dakota, but grew up in Florida. She says, I would like to thank the Deanna Williams, little Tony, and all of my friends for understanding and supporting me through all the peaks and valleys of this endeavor. She says, I have accepted an RN job at the Bay Medical Emergency Department and will further my nursing education. Thank you. Sarah Woodcock. Sarah is from Tallahassee, Florida. She would like to thank Mom, Dad, Shelby, Kyle, and my bestie girl group. She plans to work in the ER where I am currently working at the tech. Thank you. Okay. Madison Yale. Madison is from Panama City, Florida. She would like to thank my mom, Ann Yale, my fiance, Chris Bieberitz, my brother, Tyler Yale, my family in Connecticut, and my family in Panama City. She says, my plans for the future are to eventually become a mother and baby nurse, earn my bachelor's degree, and as time goes on, earn my master's degree with a specialty in nursing education. Thank you. All right. Heather Young. She says, I want to especially thank my husband, Terry Young, and my children, Willow and Weston Young, for being the most supportive family in the past 2 years. I love you three the most. She says, I currently work on a med-surg ortho unit, and as far as my future in nursing, the sky is the limit. My favorite part of nursing is all the options for future careers. Hopefully, over the years, I'll get the opportunity to enjoy a few different types of nursing and care for some amazing patients along the way. Thank you. Okay. Well, it certainly sounds like the students are from a lot of different areas of the country. We're pretty diverse. Now at the time for the class memories and reflections. The graduating students have put together a class memories PowerPoint presentation, which will be shown next. And the participants on the stage are going to leave the stage and sit in the audience so we can view the screen. And then we're going to ask for lights to be dim for the viewing, and then we'll come back to the podium after the presentation for the Nightingale Pledge and the benediction and a closing statement. Okay? All right. Time to eat. Thank you. So now at the time for the Nightingale Pledge, Florence Nightingale is noted for her contributions to the emerging field of nursing. Among one of her most noted contributions is her promotion of cleanliness and hygiene of the environment, which remains extremely important today during the emergence of new and severe disease. Students will now join in for recitation of the Nightingale Pledge, which will be led by Sydney Ward. Sydney, please come over to the podium, and she'll lead y'all in the recitation. And then the pledge is on the back of the back of your brochure.
All right, please stand. Florence Nightingale is noted for her contributions to the emerging field of nursing. Among one of her most noted contributions is her promotion of cleanliness and hygiene of the environment, which remains extremely important today. During the emergence of new and severe disease, students will now join for the recitation of the pledge. I pledge in the presence of this assembly to practice my profession faithfully. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession, and will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to by keeping and all family affairs coming to my knowledge in the practice of my profession. I will devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. You may be seated.
Thank you. Okay, thank you, Sydney. Okay, so we believe their education and life experiences in new RNs has just begun. Okay, I would be remiss if I didn't encourage these students to continue their education to pursue bachelor's and graduate degrees in nursing. And from the comments that I read as you walk across the stage, I think we do have quite a few people that are planning on continuing their education. So I commend you for that. You know, our RN to BSN program is in a hybrid format, which allows the students to continue their education while completing classes online. And I think this is a format that you've already shown that you're proficient in. So we invite your students to come back and continue education with us. So when you're ready for that, if you haven't already seen Dr. Chitwood, he's the person to contact, and we can get you started. So now is the time for the benediction, and I'd like the students and the faculty to rise for the closing benediction, which will be provided by Associate Professor Dr. Rebecca Leach. After the benediction, the faculty will exit the auditorium, followed by the students. And afterwards, well, we already done your group picture, so we've already got the picture, right? Yeah, okay. So, Dr. Leach?
First, I'd like to say congratulations. Everybody hear me okay? All right. Dear Lord, our Creator and Protector, we ask that you bestow blessings upon and provide protection to these graduates as they begin their journey into this sacred and honored profession. Help guide them and remind them that amidst darkness, there remains light, hope, and love. While this career may look at times like a hopeless endeavor, and it may seem harsh that human vessels can endure such violent weather, please, Lord, show these young nurses how to carry on with grace nonetheless. There is a point to all of this, because one moment with one person may be the very reason we are here on earth at this time. Graduates, have eyes to see and not judge. Have ears to hear, but also to listen. Have hands to heal and not harm. Have hearts to care and not be bitter. Have spirits to be fully present and not distracted. We offer up these words of comfort, strength, and encouragement in the name of all that is benevolent. To all joining us here today, may today there be peace within. May you all trust that you are exactly where you are meant to be. May you not forget the infinite possibilities that are born of faith in yourself and others. May you use the gifts that you have received and pass on the love that has been given to you. May you be content with yourself just the way you are. Let this knowledge settle into your bones and allow your soul the freedom to sing, dance, praise, and love. To the graduating class of December 2020, with gladness in your hearts and hope in your eyes, go forth and be nurses. Be strong, be well, be true, be loving. Amen.